after God has given me on my heart will help with forgiveness. A lot of times we feel like people are putting us in bondage. We've talked about traditions, older people being abused and things like that. All we have to know is that those people, they themselves are in bondage.
Yes.
You give
what
you have. If you're not free, you cannot give someone else freedom.
Right.
And so what we understand it from this standpoint, what we can give back is empathy and forgiveness.
Amen.
Amen.
So I feel prompted by the Holy Spirit to say, I also was sexually abused by my father, who was a schizophrenic. When I was only 8 years old, I didn't get a school education because my mind was paralyzed with fear. And even today, I'm still in bondage to fear.
You're free.
No, you see, if I say, I have no sin. I deceive myself, and the truth is not in me. I am not going to deny the reality, because it is about reality.
Yeah.
It is about reality. What are we really feeling? Because the Holy Spirit said to me one day, what you're feeling tells you whom you are feeling. And I know that I get impatient. Yet the Holy Spirit is patient. Like, I hate the fact that sin does reign in my mortal body. And I also fear that because I actually got physically struck when I was in a church, received a black eye and a split lip by a worship leader. That was in a Baptist church. And that was to teach me that it's not about knowledge, it's about behaviour. It's about fruit. The fruit is the proof. The fruit of the Spirit. But I'm very dissatisfied. Like, I know my Goliath, my worst enemy, is me. Like, the failure is called love. And I know I can't live right. I humble myself because God said humble yourself. And I believe we all need to do it for ourselves. Like, we all need to be real and take the mask off and really say how we're really feeling and what we've gone through. Like, we should be able to speak to one another. The Word of God declares about confessing our sins to each other, and we should be able to do it with each other without feeling that we're going to get condemned, without feeling that we're going to get accused. You see, it is really about love. I know that love is the most excellent one. I had a death experience in 1984 and had 4 foot and my intestine took away. I actually had a heart attack. And what I felt, what I encountered, I will never forget. My whole being became flooded with light and I was looking upon light. It was a very bright, white, dense light. And I know that I'm called to sing amongst the nations. God has given me a gift, and the gift is to sing.
Yep.
Like, I am one of his singers, and I've had 4 deaths. I've lost my husband, I've lost my mother, I've lost my mother's partner, and I've lost a sister in Christ. But you know what? I can honestly and sincerely say that God is good.
Yep.
God is good.
Yep.
But what the failure means is human love. Human love is a failure. We've all failed through love that does get impatient, that does keep a record of wrong. You know, I forgave my father when I learned the knowledge about evil spirits. Before I learned the knowledge about evil spirits, I hated him. I was so bitter, I could not look him in the eyes. But then when I went to a Christian shop and learned about what goes on inside a schizophrenic, these evil spirits, I wept for him. I forgave him instantly. And I felt that passion, the passion of Christ. But you know, I'm very dissatisfied with me. Like I know the Goliath that I'm facing is myself. And so I'm keeping humble, regardless of what anybody thinks of me. I'm keeping humble because I'd rather fear God than fear man. I'd rather please God than please man. So let's be God pleasers and not people pleasers. And let's stop being religious and be real.
Forgiven, set free, completed. And that's why honestly manifest here today, that people would leave here today whole, completely delivered, completely set free, mentally, physically, all of it, let's go for it. Let's believe God for that, Jesus' name.
Come on.
Ron has said a lot. Ron has said a lot again, but I'm going to try and bring it down a bit further. You've said a lot, and hallelujah. If we can all get to that level and believe and walk in that renewal of mind, hallelujah. But some of us can't. Some of us need to hold our hands. Yeah. And that's what we are trying to do today, hallelujah. So when you have been sexually abused, or when you have suffered something that as a child, I mean, for childless child, I knew your family when I was teaching. In fact, one gentleman who we were talking about nature debate in psychology, and he says he doesn't believe in nature. He believes in, he doesn't believe in nature, he believes in nature because his whole family are gods. But he made that decision at the age of 14. Not to be like his mom, his dad, and brothers or sisters. They wake up every morning and they plan to go still, who to go and rock, what to go and do. And he says, since at the age of 7, 8, he felt out of place. So at the age of 14, he left home. But some people haven't been able to do it. They've done it because that is their environment they belong in. So when you've been sexually abused or exposed to things that you didn't walk into, but you were introduced to, how do you get rid of the mental? Because it actually did happen. I know Bible says, who the Son says, please be dead, and you remember your sins no more. But those are sins that you committed, you went and committed yourself. These are things that have been against you. So for us, for those of us who have suffered those things, how does he take it away from your mind totally? Yes, it can happen instantly, but what can we do to really walk in that?
As you rightly said, in Christianity there are levels. Some are babies. Romans chapter 15, verse 1, it says, if anyone is overtaken by any trespass, let him who is spiritual restore such a one. So there is restoration needed. For restoration to take place, first, you need to sit that person down. The person must pour out everything. Because there's a saying that a problem shared is half solved. So the person must come up with all the inward hurts, pain, then you introduce that person to forgiveness. See, when forgiveness is not introduced, the Bible talking about preaching forgiveness. You see, when the person accepts love and forgive is one of the process of restoration. Then, after forgiveness takes place, you then move to the next step. Because when there is bitterness and pain, it opens your heart. You see, and when that happens, the devil comes in. He may not possess, he cannot possess if you are born again, but he can influence your mind. And it happens mostly when there is bitterness, pain, unforgiveness. See, so when the person confesses and the person forgives, then you need to move to the next level. You will be spiritual. Rebuke the spirit behind. Bible says the devil in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8, our adversary. The devil is moving about like an angry lion, seeking for whom he may devour. But the Bible says we can resist him steadfastly in the faith. So you teach the person about what Christ has done, our authority. If you are spiritual, you rebuke that spirit to leave. Then, when the spirit, you command that spirit by faith to leave, the person will be free. Then, you start introducing the person to another picture. That is who he is in Christ. Because a believer is changed by seeing who he is in the mirror. The Bible talking about we all with an open face we behold the glass of the glory of God. We are changed into the same image by the Spirit of God. So for change, the Spirit of God must be involved. Because how does the Spirit of God change a person? You need to have another image. If you forgive the person who sexually abused you, you let everything go, you shouldn't be anything. Choose freedom from every bondage. Come out of that bondage. Occupy yourself with another thing. You see, if you come out of, let's say, drugs, don't just be idle like that. Don't be neutral, okay, I'm forgiving. No, you need to create another passion. Passion for prayer, yeah. Passion for the word, passion for being among the family of God where you'll be encouraged. You see, it's very, very important for the true change to happen. Because when you're among the family of God, you hear truth. Truth will paint a picture. The Spirit of God needs you to have a picture of who you are, what you can do. That look, I was sexually abused. Now I'm free. I can have habits. God is in you. Greater is he that is in you. So you can have. So you need those pictures. Once you get those pictures, the Spirit of God will bring you to become what you see. So the truth finally is, for a Christian to be changed, we don't attack their character. First, we show them a picture. Look at you. You are righteous. You don't need to go back into bondage. This is who you are. You are holy. You are accepted. After all those forgiveness, the person must see a picture. Jen put it this way. Look at your face like a mirror and don't forget what you see. And that is where true change happens.
I don't know if there is anybody who is hard that, but your hand is up. What's the microphone? The lady sent this one. Oh, sorry. Come in. My apologies.
I don't even know why I'm feeling this way, but I feel people telling me that my mind is really shaking. I don't know if it's because I'm about to expose that I've been. Well, for the past few years, I've been a bad addict of pornography, and then I've been masturbating and a whole lot of stuff. I used to go out to buy pornographic CDs to watch whilst my